Good morning, class 9th. Let's start the new chapter, that is tissues. Plant tissue as well as animal tissue. Now, just think that a single cell is able to perform all the functions. It can move from one place to another. It can respire. It can breathe, it can respire, and also it can digest or take the food and do the digestion process. It can excrete the undigested residue from its body. Just think, the organisms whose body is made up of single cell can perform all the activities. But what about the organisms having a multicellular organization? A multicellular organisms can also perform the same function, but there occurs division of labor. Now, what do you understand by division of labor? All the work is distributed among the cells. So, children, tissue. A tissue is a group of cells performing a common function. These tissue usually belong to the same origin. Means performing the same function and also belong to the same origin. Now let us move to the next slide and study about the grade of organization. Now you all know that cell is the basic unit of life and it can perform all the functions which are required for the survival. Many cells combine together to form a specific function, and then it is called as a tissue. And when many tissue combines together, it form organ. And when many organs work together, it form a system called as organ system. And organ system together forms an organism. So this is about the grade of organization in the body. Grade of organization of the living organism. Now children, these are the human body tissues. So you have studied till now that a single cell is able to perform all the functions, but in multicellular organisms the functions are divided. Means few cells will perform the form the epithelial layer, and few cells will form the skeletal muscle, few will form the connective tissue, others will form the nervous tissue, then few of the cells will form the cardiac muscle, smooth muscle, and variety of tissues are present. So in multicellular organisms, when cells perform a specific function, those type of cells are called as specialized cells. Now when specialized cells work together, they form a tissue. Suppose this specialized cell is performing a function, then it will not be called as a tissue. But when many specialized cell work together and complete a task or perform a similar function, that is called as a tissue. Now children, I am going to tell you one example here. As in plants, you have studied the structure of a plant cell. Now you all know that in plants, the roots are responsible for absorbing the water. So these cells should be modified or adapted for absorbing the water. ये cells को अपने आप को modify करना है कि ये पानी को absorb कर सकें, because you all know that roots are responsible for the absorption of water and minerals. So what are the adaptations or the modifications it will attain to absorb the water? So in the root hair cell, you know that a large vacuole is present, this you can see, and the cell wall of the root hair cell will be thin so that water can penetrate inside it. Also, suppose this is a cell and we are going to stretch it like this. So if this structure becomes this, then it will get a large surface area for the water absorption. So children, I think this must be clear to you that the cells modify themselves or adapt themselves according to the function they perform. You have studied in chapter cell that the structure of a cell is according to the function it performs. So children, one more thing about the root hair is that because it is present below the soil, it will not be able to perform the function of photosynthesis. Will it be? No. Therefore, chloroplast will not be present or chloroplast will disappear. I think now the adaptations is clear to you all. Now, let us move on. Now, this is the example of a blood. Now, children, is blood a tissue? Just think about it. Blood is a tissue because it has variety of cells. I am underlining the cells here. You can see a monocyte, neutrophil, basophil, platelets, plasma, lymphocyte. Plasma is not a cell. Red blood cells, all are present here. But the function of blood is to carry out the things from one place to another. Though the cells are not attached, they move freely, but still it is a type of a tissue which transports the things from one place to another. So children, this was a general introduction about the tissue. Thank you.